AI is transforming everything, from healthcare to self-driving cars to financial services. Across industries, companies are using advanced AI to elevate their business and stay ahead of the competition in ways we never would have thought possible. And the data centers that support these compute and power-intensive AI workloads rely on specialized servers with high-performance processing chips that generate enormous amounts of heat. If the servers get too hot, their performance drops. So that heat has to be managed efficiently, and traditional air cooling methods just aren't gonna cut it. A super efficient way to regulate hardware temperature is with liquid cooling. This method uses pipes to circulate liquid, typically either water or a specialized coolant, to quickly and efficiently absorb heat directly from the equipment. Liquid cooling is effective because liquid conducts more than 3,000 times as much heat as air and requires less energy to do so. That efficiency allows data center operators to stack more servers into fewer racks for higher density arrangements that can meet growing processing demand while saving energy. The most common liquid cooling method for high-power, data-intensive tasks like AI is direct-to-chip cooling. Here's how it works. Chilled cooling liquid starts inside a heat exchanger, which sends it directly to the servers. This cooling fluid flows over metal plates attached right to the processing chips, pulling away the intense heat they generate. Once the heat is absorbed, the liquid flows back to the heat exchanger, where it's cooled and recirculated. But it doesn't stop there. The heat exchanger then transfers this heat to a secondary cooling loop, which rejects it from the building entirely. By combining liquid cooling with an external cooling system, data centers can efficiently manage high-power AI workloads and support next-generation digital services, all while using energy and water resources more sustainably. Now that's progress. To learn more about high-performance data centers and how they operate, check out these other videos.